It's time once again to interview a coach on the Sports Couch Show, brought to you by People's National Bank, serving you with locations throughout Southern Illinois, member FDIC and equal housing lender, and by Mount Vernon Title Company. When you need title work or real estate closings or contract for deed work, Mount Vernon Title Company. During week three of the high school football season, the Hamilton County Foxes hosted the Christopher Ziegler Royalton Bearcats in a Black Diamond Conference game, and boy, the offense was really clicking, and the defense too, for that matter, as the Foxes came away with a big 50-12 victory to move to 1-2 in the conference, 1-2 on the season. Joining us is head coach Rhett Vaughan of the Foxes, and coach, good to have you on the show, and congratulations on the win.
Hey, thank you. I appreciate it.
Boy, you everything that you worked on in week one and week two against both Cesar Valera and Carmi kind of prepared you, I guess, for week three, and you really put it all together against the Bearcats, didn't you?
Yeah, we did. We finally got some things rolling with offense. I think, like you just said, that first 2 weeks, some tough losses was kind of a pivotal moment here last Friday night. Who are we? What are we made of? And Christopher was sitting in the same boat, 0-2. And they're a very athletic team, very, very solid team. But we knew we had to get that one, and our guys showed up to play.
Well, it was really close there in the first half, and, a big score took place there right before halftime, and that kind of got the momentum rolling for you, it seemed like, huh?
Yeah, so week 1-2, we gave up a touchdown right before halftime, and that's always a real momentum shifter whenever you, someone scores right before the half. Have to go in the locker room and then, go back out there and you get the ball back or you don't get the ball back after you just gave up a touchdown. But this week, we had Eli Hansen ran back a kick right before halftime, and then we came out of halftime and got the ball back. So it was definitely a momentum shifter there, and we really didn't look back from there. We kind of just kept rolling with it after that.
Your first 2 weeks you lose to Cesar Valera and Carmi. Those are two of the better teams, of course, in the Black Diamond Conference, and they're both still sitting at 3-0 on the year, and now you're 1-2. And now you go on the road to Edwards County, a chance to pick up another victory there against the Lions.
Yeah, I mean, we've got, there's no slouch in the conference. We can't even have that mentality. I know Edwards County's, they didn't look too bad this last weekend, so there's no way we're going to underestimate anybody. We're going to go in there. It's a Saturday game, so it'll be a little bit different for us. We gotta get up, get out of bed, get moving, and get up, go up there and take care of business. And then from there, we still have Johnson City and Fairfield on the schedule. I liked what I saw the way Cesar handled Fairfield this last weekend, and Johnson City is. They're human. They're beatable. So I still think that even though we started out slow, we've got a really good chance of making playoffs.
Well, I'm going to back up to week two because, after we talked to you after the first week there against Cesar Valera, you're getting ready for Carmi. Of course, last year you didn't play very well against Carmi. They blew you out, and you were concerned about that. And going into week two against Carmi, your mindset was that, we just want to play a much better football game and be in it against Carmi. And in it you were. I mean, you lose that game 18-8, but you've got to be so pleased with how well the Foxes played against a very good Carmi team.
Yeah, I think that was not my mindset. I wanted to win it.
Sure.
I just wanted to just be in it. Our guys thought that way either. However, talking to some people from Carmi, I think that might have been their attitude was they were – maybe underestimating us a little bit going into it, and they didn't play their best game. However, we were, our defense was on the field for the majority of that game. We had a punt block and recover, that we got, took over an offense inside the five or so, and then we punched one in, and that was it for the offense the whole night. So, we just could not get anything going with our offense, and our defense was worn out from being on the field so much. But, we played a very, very close game, and up until the very end, we were right there. We were in it. We had every chance to. We could be sitting at 3-0 or 2-1 very easily. But we're a young team and we're learning from it. I think we're still sitting pretty.
Well, now that you've got three games under your belt, what do you think is the thing that you need to work on the most? Is your offense ahead of your defense? Is your defense ahead of your offense? Or what do you think you're going here as you work on practice this week to prepare for the Lions?
Yeah, sure. I think that we just got to get consistent on both sides of the ball. Even even last week when we held them to 12 points and we scored 50 points. Like, there, we watch film. There are plenty of things that we can improve on that we see, you know, in film that, you know, it reveals kind of what we're really lacking or ways that we didn't execute the game plan as well as we could have. So we've got to stay disciplined on defense, and on offense we've got to keep improving and keep making sure that we have our guys prepared for whatever defensive front gets thrown in front of us that game, the upcoming weeks, and we know how to execute regardless of who we have on the field due to injuries or what defense is out there in front of us or what the opponent's records are. We got to be just keeping our mindset with the same intensity just consistently from here on out.
All right. Well, Rhett, we appreciate your time. Again, congratulations on the win against CZR, and best of luck as you prepare for the Edwards County Lions this weekend, okay?
All right. Thanks, Randy. Appreciate it.
Thanks. Bye-bye.